ओके सर। हेलो,
रुक्मिणी
गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल। हेल्थ इज नॉट जस्ट बीइंग डिजीज फ्री, हेल्थ इज व्हेन एवरी सेल इन योर बॉडी इज बाउंसिंग विद जॉय। द आइडियल फूड फॉर योर बॉडी इज व्हाट लीव्स यू अलर्ट, एजाइल एंड एक्टिव। Anne Violet Arts and Science College takes the liberty to upgrade the students via the web series on New Insights in Science. Myself, Dr. A. Rohini, Assistant Professor, Department of Biochemistry, takes the entitlement to welcome you all for the web series. It's my privilege to welcome our founder and chairman, Chevalier Dr. N. R. Dhanapalan, Anne Violet Group of Institutions. Secretary Sir, Mr. N. R. D. Premkumar, Joint Secretary Sir, Dr. P. E. R. Premchand, Principal Ma'am, Dr. Kamala Balakrishnan, Vice Principal Ma'am, Mrs. Zafia Solomon, heads of various departments and faculty members from our institution, as well as from the other institutions and the student participants. I would like to welcome you all for the web series scheduled to be conducted by the Science Department of our institution from 4th of August to 10th of August 2020. The core discussion of this web series will include day one, be conscious of digestion to lead healthy life, junk food versus natural food by the Department of Biochemistry. Day two, machine learning, the Department of Computer Science and Computer Application. Day three, resilience during uncertain times by the Department of Chemistry. Day four, application of Vedic mathematics by the Department of Mathematics. Day five, glimpse of forensic science by the Department of Microbiology, respectively. Department of Biochemistry is starting with day one, topic, be conscious of digestion to lead healthy life, junk food versus natural food. The talk will be delivered by Dr. M. Arulyothi, Assistant Professor, Department of Biochemistry, Chennai National Arts and Science College, Avadi. There's a famous quote, junk food satisfies you for a minute. Being fit satisfies you for life. Good nutrition is an important part of a leading healthy lifestyle. Combined with physical activity, your diet can help you to reach and maintain a healthy weight, reduce your risk of chronic diseases like heart disease and cancer, and promote the overall health. Natural food, as nature deliberated, fresh, raw fruits and vegetables, along with vital vitamins, minerals and phytonutrients, leads to a positive natural state of physical and mental health and vibrancy. And the junk food can be treat to the taste buds, but the ill effects of these foods can hamper your development and may eventually make your brain weak and non-functional. So with this, I welcome you all once again for this web series conducted by our institution. Now I would like to call our principal ma'am, Dr. Kamala Balakrishnan, to share a few words with you.
Good evening all. Yeah, good evening all.
Good evening, ma'am.
Yeah, let me first congratulate the IQAC coordinator and Science Department HODs for coming out with this wonderful series of webinars. And today, everyone is waiting for scientists to come out with the vaccine to cope up with this COVID-19. So everyone waiting for you to come out with solution for this pandemic. And during this pandemic time, we don't want to leave the students as well as faculty members. And they are conducting many programs like webinars, quiz, and competitions for students. And now since the University of Madras and the government insisted to start a regular college starting from yesterday. So this efforts taken by science department is really wonderful. And once again, I congratulate the organizer and all the best for the science department. And my humble request is please pass this web series message to all so that everyone can benefit it. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I extend a warm welcome to our guest speaker, Dr. M. Arulajyoti, Chennai National Arts and Science College, Avadi. Okay, welcome you, ma'am.
My job is over.
All the participants are requested to post their queries in the chat box and kindly fill the feedback link at the end of the session to get your e-certificates. Now, Dr. Harini, Assistant Professor, Department of Biochemistry, will introduce the resource person. Over to Dr. Harini.
Thank you, Dr. Rohini. Good evening, everyone. Myself, Dr. R. Harini, Assistant Professor, Department of Biochemistry, takes the great pleasure to introduce our speaker today, who is going to talk about be conscious of digestion to lead healthy life. Our speaker, Dr. M. Arulajyoti, is working as an assistant professor, Chennai National Arts and Science College, Avadi. She has got more than 5 years of teaching experience. She pursued her doctorate from Bharati Women's College and Loyola College. Her research work mainly focused on diabetes mellitus, cancer studies, and related metabolic disorders in vivo. She published her research work on reputed journals and conferences at national and international level, and also participated in many workshop and training sessions to upgrade her research skills. She is an expert in advanced wet lab technique. Adding to her merit, she was awarded fellowship by University of Madras for her first rank in MPhil. With this introduction, we are happy to introduce the young dynamic woman scientist, Dr. M. Arulajyoti, to start the webinar session. I hope this session will be more informative to all of us. Once again, I welcome you all. Now, yeah, I request our resource person to take over the session.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Yeah, respected Surya Dr. N. Dhanabalan, sir, founder and chairman. Respected Mr. N.R.D. Prem Kumar, secretary. Respected Dr. P.E.R. Premchand, Joint Secretary. Respected Dr. Kamala Balakrishnan, Principal. Respected Mrs. Jafia Salaman, Vice Principal. Respected Dr. A. Chandramohan, Head of the Department of Biochemistry, and entire team of Annaviolet College of Arts and Science, and dear participants, good afternoon, one and all. So the Annaviolet College vision is very much impression to me. So our impression, college vision is education to all. I remember one thing, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam sir says, education is the most powerful weapon which can use to change the world. So I thank Annaviolet Arts and Science College management to give opportunity to take webinar session. So today's topic is be conscious of digestion to lead healthy life. I'm Dr. M. Arulajyoti, Assistant Professor, Department of Biochemistry, Chennai National Arts and Science College, Avadi, Chennai. Let me move to the topic. So, what is digestion? Digestion is the process of larger molecules of food is cut into or converted into smaller molecules of food, and the energy is absorbed by the blood. Simple concept, what is the digestion? What is the energy is absorbed, what the level, okay? The digestive system consists of two major parts. One is major organs, another one is accessory organs. Major organs including mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, and large intestine. The accessory organs means liver, gallbladder, and pancreas. So this slide shows follow the image. Mouth is the first part of the digestive system, the mouth is maintained a pH is 7. pH means nothing but it's a hydrogen ionic concentration. So hydrogen ionic concentration 7 is a neutral way. So our mouth is secreted by saliva. So the saliva pH is 7. This is the entry point of food. Then the food is cut into a teeth with the purpose of cut, tear, crush and grind the food. So main purpose is salivary glands. The salivary gland produce and secrete the saliva into the oral cavity. What is saliva? It is a moisture of a food. It contains the enzymes. For example, tylin or salivary amylase is the beginning of the digestion of starch into the smaller polysaccharides. The main function of the mouth is mechanical digestion and increasing the surface area for faster chemical digestion. So then the food is entered into the esophagus. Now, esophagus is nothing but a tube and connecting to the mouth to the stomach. So it is running through the thoracic cavity. The main location is it lies behind the windpipe. So the trachea has the epiglottis. Epiglottis is a mainly the trachea is a preventing the food from entering the windpipe. It's mainly moving to the food to the esophagus and while swallowing. This is a picture express the esophagus to connect the stomach. So food travel into the esophagus to stomach. Some movements is occur. This movement is known as a peristalsis. For example, the heart pumping is laptop movement. Laptop sound is here. So that for that examples for at the same time the stomach, the esophagus to the stomach, the food travel into this space is called a and the time is the movement of food travel into the esophagus to stomach is called a peristalsis movement. The main function of esophagus is the lining of esophagus secretes mucus and lubricating to support the movement of food. Next slide shows the esophageal sphincter. This diagram shows the esophagus, lower esophageal sphincter and pyrolic sphincter. Last one is a duodenum. The structure is expressed as a J letters. So it's a bolus reaches the stomach. Bolus means it's a food bolus reaches the stomach. Must passes through the muscular ringed wall. It's called the esophageal sphincter. The shape is J shape. The main function of the esophageal sphincter is it prevents the stomach acid from back following to the esophagus. This slide shows the structure of stomach. So the structure of stomach is J shape. This is only muscular sac. It's a the natural. The nature is a muscular sac. Her inner fold is a rucosal. It increasing the surface area of stomach. What are the functions of stomach means? It's a perform mechanical digestion. Two digestion is have. One is a mechanical digestion and one other is a chemical digestion. So stomach is a one part of the mechanical digestion. How the function is applicable? So the polis of food and mixing it with the gastric juice. Gastric juice is nothing but it's a gallbladder, liver and pancreas. Getting a mixture of juices is called a gastric juice. It's secreted by the lining of stomach. So gastric juice means it's a HCl, salts, enzymes, water and mucus level. So what is the role of HCl in stomach means? It kill bacteria and another microorganism. It help to break down of food and kill the any toxic materials to our food materials. The polis is now in this time is called a chyme. So what are the enzymes present in the stomach means is the acidic environment. The HCl secretion only kill microbes and bacteria and other toxic substances in the pores. It's creating a pH of 2. The mucus prevents the stomach from digesting itself. Next one is the pepsin secretion. It's responsible for initiating the breakdown of protein in a food and hydrolyze the protein to yield polypeptides. The pH of 2, the enzyme from the salivary gland, and stop the breaking down of carbohydrates. So the enzyme in the stomach means it has a lot of 5 secretion is there. One is the HCl secretion, another one is the pepsin secretion. Next one is the small intestine. So small intestine having 3 main parts. One is the bolding letter, duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. So the small intestine responsible for the all macromolecules. So complete digestion of macromolecules is present in a small intestine. For example, glucose, glycerol, fatty acids, amino acids, and nucleotides are all the molecules are absorbed in the small intestine. These are the 3 parts of the small intestine. This is the main folding of the small intestine. Okay, this will explain the first part of the small intestine, duodenum. This images explain the duodenum. So it's the shortest section, but it contains lot of ducts. One is the pile duct, main pancreatic duct, and hepatopancreatic abular tube duct. So first one is the pile duct. It delivers the pile from the liver. Okay, it's a, for example, pile pigments, it's secreted by the bilirubin, biliverdin. It's a over secretion of bilirubin. It causes, it leads to a jaundice. Jaundice, all are know about the jaundice. It's a yellowish of eyes and yellowish of the body. So it's a yellow pigment. It's secreted by the pile ducts. Second one, the main pancreatic duct. It carries the pancreatic juice from the pancreas. So pancreas is one of the main organ. It's only depending on the insulin secretion level. So insulin dependent diabetes is mostly occur in the pancreatic lesions. Then hepatopancreatic abula, where the two connected and then opened it into the duodenum via the major duodenal papillae. So duodenum is a very shortest section. It contains 4 ducts present in the duodenum. Next one is the jejunum. The jejunum is approximately 2.5 meter long. Although some digestion is completed here, it has a more villi and microvilli. This structure is a long tube-like structures. It is a role mainly absorption of nutrients, all nutrients. And ileum, the ileum is approximately 3 meter long, has fewer villi and microvilli than other 2 parts. So microvilli and villi is present in both jejunum and ileum. So the shape is like a stand like tube-like structures. So although it absorb also occur here, it's responsible for the pushing of the waste material into the large intestine. So what is the absorption in the small intestine? The main function, the nutrients are absorbed by the small intestine and transported to the bloodstream. So the main absorption, the absorption of energy is started from the small intestine. The main of the energy is absorbed and delivered to the bloodstream. The nutrients are absorbed by the process of simple diffusion, simple and passive diffusion, facilitated diffusion, primary active transport, or secondary active transport. The mainly lipids are mainly absorbed and processed by undergoes the passive or simple diffusion method, and short chain fatty acids absorbed by the process of diffusion method, amino acids absorbed by the process of primary active transport method, glucose is absorbed and absorbed by the process of secondary active transport method, and fructose is absorbed by the process of facilitated diffusion method. And another absorption is the small intestine mainly absorbed by the water level. 80% of the water is absorbed by the small intestine and 10% of the water is absorbed by the large intestine and remaining 10% is excreted in the feces. So small intestine is mainly absorbed by the water level. So the body is our body is mainly 80% of the level is in mainly by water consumption, water making. Second one is the electrolytes. Electrolytes means it's nothing but the calcium, magnesium. These are the electrolytes. So it's mainly using for the transport of signaling processing. So the third one is the vitamins and minerals. So vitamins are all are know about the water soluble vitamins, fat soluble vitamins, A, D, E, K, and B1, B2 vitamins. So all the vitamins are absorbed by the small intestine. And minerals means calcium, potassium, phosphorus, and all the minerals also absorbed in the small intestine. This slide shows the components of large intestine. So the large intestine have three main parts: cecum, colon, and rectum. So the colon has four parts. One is the ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, sigmoid colon. First, we'll see about the cecum. This is a pouch-like structure. This is the first section of large intestine. This look like, you see the image, it's look like a pouch-like, pouch shape. It's 2 inches long. The main role is digest liquid from ileum. For example, a small intestine. It passes it to the colon. Second part is the colon, major section of the large intestine. The main function is water reabsorption. Absorption is different, reabsorption is different. Absorption, the 80% of the water is absorbed in the small intestine and another water reabsorption is done by the large intestine, particularly in the colon portion. So absorb the salts when needed. All the salts are absorbed. All the salts are not absorbed, but the needed salt is only absorbed by the colon portion. What are the components present in the four parts? Ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, and sigmoid colon. First one is the ascending colon. This is the first portion of the colon. This is the undigested debris up from the cecum. Just underwrite the right lower end of the liver. This position is the right lower end of the liver. Second one is the transverse colon. This is the second portion of the colon. The food traveling from left to right just under the stomach. This is a position for the colon present. Third one is the descending colon. This is the third portion of the colon. This is mainly present in down of the lower left side of the your abdomen. Then sigmoid colon. This is the final colon. This is the S shape and length of the colon. So empties into the rectum. So this slide shows the rectum. This is the final section of the large intestine. It measures from the 1 to 1.6 inches length, centimeter length. Centimeter means it's a 2.5 to 4 centimeter in length. It's a leftover the waste collect materials and expanding the rectum and emptied through the anus. So these are the slides mainly expressed the functions of large intestine. Small intestine absorb large amount of water, electrodes and vitamins and minerals. Then the large intestine absorb water, some absorb the vitamins. One by one I will explain. So first one, absorb the water. Primary functions, primary water is absorbed by the small intestine. The remaining portion of the water is absorbed by the large intestine. Then the waste as a solid stool will be expelled from the body. This is the main functions. Another one is the vitamins. It's a beneficial bacteria is absorbed by the large intestine. For example, E. coli and some beneficial bacteria is absorbed by the large intestine. The role of breaking down undigested sugar and fibers into the fat acids. Then last one is produce many vitamins, of which vitamins K and biotin, that are absorbed back into the body. Third one is reduce the acidity. So acidity means, if we are known about the acidity, is what is the nature of the acidity, you understand. So the fatty acids causes the acidic environment. The large intestine produce the alkali solution. So in the acidic nature, the large intestine produce the alkaline solution to maintain the pH of the intestine, to reduce the acidity and balance the pH of the large intestine. Then fourth one is protect from the infection. The mucus lining of the large intestine act as a protective layer. It prevents the harmful bacteria and harmful virus and bacteria and some of the toxic things from being reabsorbed into the body. Final function is, it's produce the antibodies. It also produce the antibodies. It helps to boost the immunity. It is believed that the appendix may have a major producer of antibodies at some point of in the evolutionary process. Appendix means it's nothing but it's a small ejection of the large intestines. It's a connection process. Then the slide shows the first slide explains the what are the digestive organs, what are the accessory organs. So next, before the slides completed for the digestive organs, this slide shows the accessory organs. So three main accessory organs are there. First one is the liver, gallbladder and pancreas. This is a support of the digestive system, but not for the digestive tract. Okay. These organs are secreted and built into the digestive tract and are connected by the ducts. So first one is the liver. Liver is the largest organ of the body. The weight is 1.5 kilogram. Okay. This is the first organ. The whatever thing, whatever you eat, the metabolism starts from the liver. So liver produces the bile. Pile means it's a greenish yellow pigment made up of it's a pile pigments and pile cells. Pile pigment means it's a bilirubin and biliverdin. It is a mainly it's a the level is so high it occurs it leads to a jaundice disorder. It a breakdown of old red blood cells. Second one is the gallbladder. This is a structure of gallbladder. What is the location? What to here you see the diagrams also. This is a storage sac. Okay, what is a storage sac means? This is a pile is secreted into it. The pile is stored here. Okay, how it is work means the food is the food containing fat. It will enter into the digestive tract. The salts are secreted into the small intestine to digest the fat substances. The pile emulsifies the fat into partly digestive food, thereby assisting their absorption level. Third one is the main organ. This is a pancreas. The pancreas secreted a number of different enzymes into the small intestine. The role of digest carbohydrates, lipids, protein completely. So all our food is mainly rich in carbohydrates, lipids and protein. These three foods are mainly digested by the pancreas. It also secretes the bicarbonate ions also. The main role of pancreas is it's a neutralize the HCl from the stomach and changes the pH of the small intestine to a pH of 8. So the normal pancreatic juice is 1 liter per day. So this is a overview of the digestion process. What is the digestive system? What are the accessory organs? These three. Let me see for the small video for the what is the digestion, what it absorb and enter into the body, what are the section and what is how to it eliminate. So small video, let us see. So today we learn about the digestive system. We are very well known about food provide the energy to body. Energy, it is a day from a body in a tiny cells in our body. So food eatly, for example, rice, vegetables and fruits cannot be directly used by our body to get energy. The breaking down of food inside our body is known as digestion. Digestion takes place in so many steps. There are several organs in the body that help in digestion. Look here, this is a digestion of a diagram of digestive system. First one is the mouth, esophagus, liver, gallbladder, stomach, pancreas, large intestine, small intestine, rectum. Together they make your digestive system. Okay, now I closely observe the digestive works. As you know, the food enters into the mouth, cut into small pieces. This mixed with saliva, it comes from the salivary gland. Then the food travels into the esophagus and then into the stomach. When the food leaves the stomach and is started the journey of the small intestine. Digestive juices from the liver, gallbladder and pancreas help right now the body, so the body can decide as a energy after the absorption of the energy of the food. The food travel into the large intestine. In large intestine, absorb the water, vitamins and minerals. Finally, it travel to the large intestine to rectum. It is emitted through the anus. The breaking down of food into the small pieces is called a digestion. Digestion takes place in a digestive system of our body. The digestion starts in the mouth and continues to the stomach and completed in a small intestine. The digested food is absorbed into the blood in small intestine. The undigested food is eliminated from the body through the anus. Don't worry, I will tell you to keep your digestion system healthy and strong. To avoid overeating, do not eat too much of food with your capacity. And drink the water before meals after 15 minutes period and 30 to 45 minutes after meals. So after meals you drink a water is good. It will helpful for the good digestion process. It's a eliminate the packaged food and fast food should be removed from your diet. So the healthy food is improve your good digestion process, grains, vegetables, legumes and fruits. This can improve the digestive system. So, and sit down to eat the breakfast, lunch, snacks and dinner at the same time and each day. So everybody should exercise, do exercise regularly. It will boost your immune system. It will fight against the infection, including the COVID-19. Taking this step to heart processing is a smoothly and healthy. So this section is the fully digestion session is over. Then we'll move to the junk food. So all of you very eager to know the junk food. All of you know the junk food, but what are the risk is there, but not concentrate for the negative thoughts of the junk foods. Okay, then we will enter into the junk food. Okay, what is junk food? Simply, the junk food explainers deserve more calories and including more sugar, more fat. So, no little bit of protein and vitamins. So, you have to imagine it what the digestive system is works. What is the mechanism and functioning of food? So, normally the food, how to enter into our mouth and how to processing and all the system is you know. Okay, then you eat a junk food, what are the disturbance of your digestive system can face it. Okay, so junk food is a term of food containing high levels of calories from sugar or fat with a little protein and vitamins. Simple. Then the term was coined by the Michael Jacobson, director of Center of Science in Public Interest in 1972. These are our loving junk foods. So these are the some popular food chains. So why we give a preference to junk food? Simply sitting and booking online mobile to knock the door and get it and to eat. Simple concept. Okay. It's everywhere and quick, easy, cheap and taste is very good. So the taste is the little bit across the junk food shop, the tongue buds are very eager to catch the food. Okay. The smell is very attractive and to sit and eat the junk foods. Okay. So in overall Gulf news is a main ratio for how people eat the junk food. More the result is 72% of the people eat fast food at least once in a week. So you calculate how many people are addicted in junk foods. So what is the junk food contains? Do you know we are well educated? So do you explain the what is the junk food? What is the feedback? What is the negative of junk food? Whatever you eat, what is the positive and negative? Do you know? Okay. When previous slide, fully absorption or digestion slide, you imaginate what you eat junk food. The what is the disturbance and what is the factor affecting your health? Okay, so the junk food contains saturated fat, sugar, salt. Okay, saturated fat, sugar, salt. Okay, no more fruits, vegetables or dietary fibers. Some amount of proteins, vitamins and minerals is there, including highly processed food items. Okay, so normally you are know about the junk foods or chips, and then when the carbonated beverage, popcorn, pizza, burger, these are all the junk foods items. It's mainly depending on the ingredients and preparation method. Okay, in all the items, for example, in children's items also, and whatever junk food items are mainly make up of in a sugar fat composition. So what are the side effects of sugar? So regular use of sugar, it's the same effect of alcohol consumption. Okay, so regular use of sugar can overload your liver. So liver is the main organ to start the metabolic activity in our body. So it overloading the sugar, it will affect the liver function. It will damage all the organs activity. Another one is sugar can cause the diabetes and metabolic problem. In each family, no diabetic patients, not at all in diabetic patients and blood pressure patients. So sugar, please don't use for the sugar component. Okay. Then fat is increased due to the sugar. Okay, fat is the main problem. Fat is increased due to the sugars. Okay, sugar can damage the heart. Not at all for the liver, in all organs. Sugar and alcohol can same efforts on our body. So now I'm not taking alcohol. No, you eat a sugar, it's equal to the alcohol consumption. Okay. So regular use of sugar can increase the blood pressure also. Why junk food is so attractive? It's a no more explanation. It's a very simplicity. That's why. So junk food attraction is a high because of its simplicity. Okay. They are very easy to prepare and very tasty. The taste buds are very eager to next time I will eat. Next time what you eat? This mind is focused on junk foods. Time factor is the one reason to eat the junk foods. Whatever thing you have yourself, you have a lot of hassles and time. When you are hurry eating pizza and burger, as though are served as a you are doorstep hot and ready to eat. Okay, this next one is the taste factor. This eating junk food, it's a great taste, also causes the reusing the factors, and you keep going on. You keep going on. Your mind is fixed for the taste. Then once you are catch in a junk addiction, you find out in a hard thing to lose our nutrition junk food and pushes onto you. So some examples of potato and samosas, French fries, etc. are the great examples of the perfect taste factor. The crossing of samosa and potato chips, the taste buds and brain is smelling on and go to catch the food. Oh, another one is the advertising factor. The advertising is a very much impressed to eat the children. Mainly the junk food is affected by the children in young generations. So in probably it's a continue to the it's a prolonged to eat a junk food. It's a harmful effect to face it all this. The junk food is the backing of label is an incomplete nutrition label. The food companies tried not to show the nutrition label, especially sugar, in order to keep the profits coming. They are not showing for the complete nutrition. For example, sugars are not labeled, especially in bars and chocolates. The most companies are not showing full nutrition growth. It's a name shake and publicity shake only purpose, not for the health related one. So hereafter doing junk food, you are imagine what is the level for it. Okay, you starting the junk food, it becomes more than 5 to 6 years, your body is what becomes. So this slide shows lack of energy and fatigue. So the junk food habit, it's lacking energy and fatigue. So why it's what is the effort is occurring? This is known as a short-term adverse effect resulting from eating junk foods, as it does not provide you essential nutrients. Even though they can be very much suffering, you feel a weakened. So means it you fully eat it, but not cured for the mind activities, not, but it's a lazy one, tiredness is all the symptoms is occur, but starting is not, but it's usually you take a junk food addiction, you face it in the problems. So lack of concentration in young children, it's a lack of a concentration means it's a lot of, it's a not focusing on studies and another works. It is a simply sitting and doing for mobile chatting and whatever thing. So main problem is a heart problem. Junk food is a major causes of heart disease. First one is a myocardial infarction. Next one is a hypertension. You are know about high blood pressure. Third one is atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis means nothing but it's a hardening of blood vessels, the hard blood vessels. So one example for new tap is first time you use a new tap, the water flow is very much fast. After you using more than 5 to 6 years, the tap water is it's a lacking of waste material and all those. The force of water become low level. So that is an example for atherosclerosis. Means it's a fat. The junk food is mainly consist of a packing on a fat. The overall fat is deposited in the hot blood vessels. So the hot blood vessels, it's a joining is a deposition, means it's a hardening of hot blood vessels. So this heart problem is known as a atherosclerosis. Okay. Then one is a peripheral vascular diseases, ischemic heart diseases. Okay. This is a heart related problems. Another one is a high cholesterol level. So it will increase. So junk food is mainly composed of only for the fat. So fat is leading to the cholesterol, high to the cholesterol level. Apart from forming, it's a constricting arthritis, and cholesterol also affects liver where it is metabolized. High cholesterol from junk food and diet strains liver damaging it's eventually. Okay, so the organ, so the metabolism is starting from the liver. It will damage the liver, means it's a whole organ system is collaborate. This is a long-term effort. For one time I use the junk food, this problem is I face it. No. Those, this is a long-term effort. You can follow 5 years, 6 years, means this is a obesity. It causes the obesity also. This using a junk food in long term, it's a long-term effort. So obesity, simply all I know about the obesity, it occurs the more fat, carbohydrate, processed sugar and less fibers is consumed. 187 extra calories per day, leading to 6 pounds of additional gain in a weight per year. Okay, so 187 calories vandu per day la increase aaduna ungalku overall 6 pounds additional gains vandu per year ku increase aagum. Okay, then increase the risk of other diseases. Other diseases means obesity based related diseases, diseases can occur. Next one is diabetes. Diabetes is nothing but it's a metabolic disorder. It is three types of diabetes can occur. One is type 1 diabetes. It is insulin dependent diabetes mellitus. Type 2 is non-insulin dependent diabetes mellitus. Third one is gestational diabetes. In type 1 means it's children's based. So mainly father by birth child. So for maximum 5 years, children can affect the type 1 diabetes. And type 2 diabetes is mainly caused by the obesity, food habit and genetical carrier also. Then type 3 diabetes is gestational diabetes. This diabetes is only occur by the women's in pregnancy times. Okay, after the delivery it appears, but you can follow the diet also. It increasing the incidence of the teenagers. Okay, then the nutrient deficiency. Nutrient deficiency means nothing but the vitamin deficiency. Vitamins means vitamin A, D, E, K and B complex vitamins, all the vitamins deficiency. For example, vitamin A means it's a blurry visions, the short visions. As for the examples, all the vitamin deficiencies also occur. Anemia means it's a decrease of hemoglobin level in our blood. And osteoporosis means the softening of bone. Bone is the thickest element. An osteoporosis patient means it's the bone is very softening. So little skip, the bones is broken. Okay, this is a type 2 diabetes. It's very much, it's increasing the blood sugar levels and including the weight gain. And it causes the, it's type 2 diabetes is occur 90 to 95% of the people can occur the type 2 diabetes. Okay, it also increase the high blood pressure. The junk food is usually very high in sodium, which contribute to the high blood pressure, which increase the risk of type 2 diabetes. So, and it also increases the triglycerides and type of fat is present in the blood. And it also increases the triglycerides level and the lipids level and all the levels developing for the type 2 diabetes. So this is the obesity. not for the simple word of obesity. So the diabetes, the obesity can distribute the various diseases. First one, heart diseases, hypertension, osteoarthritis, and obstructive sleep and apnea, and hyperlipidemia and type 2 diabetes. So simply, you know, obesity is a simply known single word for obesity. It's a totally spoil your healthy life. So what is depression? So depression means the hormonal changes that puberty make a teen susceptible to mood swing and behavioral changes also. Yeah, healthy diet keeps the hormonal levels on even whereas the junk food fails. So overall, 58% increase in risk of depression. Next one is the gastrointestinal effects. So gastrointestinal effects means is the junk food induce the gastrointestinal effects. One is the nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, constipation, bloating of stomach, lack of appetite, stomachache, and peptic ulcer. These are the mainly affect the gastrointestinal tract. It's mainly affected for the digestion purpose also. So stress can lead to poor eating habits. Poor, simply the word stress means nothing but it lead to the poor eating, and it's a forgetting water, it's a skipping for breakfast, then trying to fad diets and consuming unhealthy foods. Sometimes it's eating a overeating. So the stress induces a lot of metabolic processing, and our health is totally destroyed and disturbed. So today, more than 95% of all chronic diseases is caused by the food choice and toxic food ingredients and nutritional deficiencies and lack of physical exercise. The physical exercise is a must. So what is junk food addiction? The junk food addiction is similar to the drug addiction. Okay. So the literature review, the studied in rat population, they overeat the junk food when they're taken off this diet and refuse to eat the healthy food. And that during the pregnancy and increase the intake and increases the unhealthy eating habits of offspring. Okay. So it is similar to the drug addiction in a human. It is a possibility for the neurotransmitter for like a dopamine. It may influence the habitual eating patterns. So it's a junk food. It lead to the loss of nutrients in a healthy food. Okay. The food addiction is not a joke. Okay. It's eating junk food alters the brain activity in a way and similar to addictive drugs such as cocaine and heroin. Okay, all the junk foods are not healthy, but nowadays the little bit changes for the junk food items. So you have to check it and make use of the junk food. Not preferable, but you can check it. Okay, in products of the food industries and companies and restaurant, some limitation to change the junk food. For example, sugar-free foods and when the whole grains foods, for example, potato chips, then sandwich, the whole wheat bread sandwich, salads and diet soda and zero calories and sugar-free soda. These are the making of free junk foods, free healthy junk foods items. So you have to check it and analyze in case you have to use it, but you can realize and compare to the another one. Okay. So what is healthy diet? Okay. So healthy diet means it's a combination of food. Okay. This is a micronutrients, macronutrients, and then fibers, then fruits and vegetables. These are the combination to lead the healthy diet and healthy life. So diet is a help and maintain and improve your health. So you can decide what type of food is you eat, it improve or not. Okay. It involves the consuming appropriate amount of all nutrients. For example, macronutrients, micronutrients, carbohydrates, fats, proteins, and the, all the mixture of food is a healthy diet. So most probably, many chronic health risk is a, it's a healthy diet is a prevention of the many chronic health risks such as obesity, heart disease, diabetes, and cancer. This is a combination of the junk food and healthy food. You can imagine the alternate the foods of healthy food and junk food. So this is a food pyramid. How to eat and how, what is the eatable habits and what is the percentage to eat and what are the mechanism for how to regularize your life means. First one, your daily physical exercise in every time, every day, and follow for the following the regular timing also. And drink more water because our body is 80% in a water level. Okay. Then the corn, cereals, bread, noodles, 6 to 10%, for example, 40% we can use these items. Then the vegetables is a 20% and fruits is a 2 to 4 portions. The overall the 15% we can use the fruits and vegetables. Then dairy product means is a milk product. This is a usage of 12% and another meat, fish, egg. So non-veg item is a 12%. Do you not eat a non-veg? It's a no problem. Okay. Then 1% is adding for a fat, butter, oil, sugar, biscuit, etc. So 1% is having a sugar, but 100% is using for a sugar in everyday life today. So hereafter, walking, but running through the junk food hereafter, okay? So avoid junk food. Try to understand that junk food causes the loss of health and stamina. This habit would be eventually reduce the power of immune system of body. This thing eventually comes into the addiction and diseases would prevail. Okay. Okay, now you can ask, okay, what you eat? Okay, you eat a healthy and nutrition foods. You eat a variety of nutrition rich food and enjoy the blend of whole grains, fruits and vegetables, and maintain the healthy weight and eat moderate portion, not for full diet and full meals. Okay, eat regular meals and reduce, don't eliminate the certain foods, don't vomit or any vegetables, any fruits, to eat all the vegetables and fruits also. So this session, the conclusion for that, in healthy life, the four things is mainly added. First one is exercise regularly. So the exercise regularly means we can exercise regular time, the every day in each time, the particular time. Okay, you can fix a time for morning 6 to 7 or whatever thing. You can regular the timing also. And evening means it's a regularize for the evening exercise. Okay, but every day you should do the exercise. Okay, it will improve your immune system also. The immune system will lead to improve the all the infections and diseases. For example, COVID-19 is also. Okay, so forget to exercise regularly. Okay, then second one is eat healthy. So a lot of time I will, I'm telling you. So eat healthy means it's your food is mainly the composition of carbohydrates, fats and proteins and fruits, vegetables and fibers. Okay, not eat for the junk food. Okay, in case you have to interest to junk food in a one time means you have to follow the background whole sandwich items. So you have to follow the some instructions. Okay, sugar free items and soda free item you have to follow. This is the eat healthy items. Okay, then third one is that drink plenty of water. So in a yearly wake up you have to drink water at least over 250 ml or 500 of liter of water is must. Why? The digestive system is completely locked in for a whole night. So the system is starting means it's a you have to drink a water. The system, digestive system is functioning. Once you don't drink the water, directly you eat the food, it's a you feel, okay, the stucking of a digestion process, the blockages, some difference you feel. Okay, you have to follow one thing. In every day you must drink a water after brushing. Okay, so drink plenty of water. In daytime you have to drink more water, and night you have to slow a little bit slow down the consuming the little amount of water. Okay, then reduce the stress. Stress means your interest, you listen the music or listening whatever you interest, but you try to yoga, meditations and prayer, whatever thing you reduce your stress. Okay, so in a healthy life, make a regular exercise, eat healthy, drink plenty of water and reduce the stress. Okay, thank you for your attention and don't forget to eat right. Thank you so much. Any questions?
Unmute, madam.
Thank you, ma'am. It was really very informative session, and I'm sure the students were enriched with the knowledge about the human digestive system, beneficial effect of healthy fresh food, whether fruits or vegetables, and the harmful effects of junk food, as well as what to eat on the right time. Well, thank you so much, ma'am. It's a gentle reminder to all the participants to post their queries in the chat box and kindly fill the feedback link to get your e-certificate at the end of the session. I would like to call Dr. A. Chandramohan, Head, Department of Biochemistry, to deliver the vote of thanks. Over to Dr. Chandramohan.
Thank you, ma'am. Good day to everyone. I am Dr. A. Chandramohan, Head of the Department Biochemistry, Annavalet Arts and Science College. A small information for all the participants that tomorrow webinar session will be conducted by the Department of Computer Application on the topic of machine learning, and the resource person is Dr. S. Bharathidasan from Loyola College. Again, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to propose vote of thanks on behalf of Annavalet Arts and Science College. I like to thank our chairman, Dr. N. R. Dhanapalan, our secretary, M. N. R. D. Prem Kumar, our joint secretary, Dr. Prem Chand, our principal, Dr. Kamala Balakrishnan, and our vice principal, Jafia Solomon, for encouraging and guiding us to conduct this webinar on behalf of the Department of Biochemistry. My sincere thanks to the presenter for today's webinar, Dr. M. Arul Jodi, Assistant Professor, Department of Biochemistry, Chennai National College, Avadi, who accepted our invitation and also shared our valuable knowledge with us. Thank you, ma'am. I thank all the HODs, faculty members, and students of our college and other college for their valuable time spent for this webinar. I also thank our technical team members, Vivinesh Kumar, Vinod, and Loganathan for their valuable support. Thank you all. Have a good day. We will see you on tomorrow session.